back there is huge! Where the hell did they find that truck?
Yeah. Okay, we're here, Tom. You get Sam out. I'm gonna go wake up the doc.
Sam. We made it. We're at the doctor's house.
Three, I owe you.
What are you doing here so late?
Evening, Doc. Sorry to wake you, but we had a little accident. We got an injured man out here.
All right, bring him inside.
Okay, thank you. Okay, I'll stay with Sam. You can take the truck back. Call it a night.
No, I'll wait.
The doc's already got his hands full. No sense in both of us breathing down his neck.
Go on, Tom. I'm gonna be fine. Okay.
Hey. You did good tonight.
Presidential address delivered earlier this year on the topic of the National Recovery Administration. This is part of our series looking back over the president's plans and results since his inauguration.
While we are making this great common effort, there should be no discord and no dispute. This is no time to cavil or to question the standards set by this universal agreement. It is time for patience and understanding and cooperation. The workers of this country have rights under this law which cannot be taken from them, and nobody will be permitted to whittle them away. But, on the other hand, no aggression is now necessary to attain those rights. The whole country will be united to get them for you. Principle that applies to the employers applies to the workers as well. And I ask you workers to cooperate in the same spirit. When Andrew Jackson, Old Hickory, died, someone asked, will he go to heaven? The answer was, he will if he wants to. If I am asked whether the American people will pull themselves out of this depression, I answer, they will if they want to. The essence of the plan is a universal limitation of hours of work per week for any individual by common consent. Forces. I have no sympathy with the professional economists who insist that things must run their course and that human agencies can have no influence on economic ills. My reason is that I happen to know that professional economists have changed their definition of economic laws every 5 or 10 years for a very long time. But I do have faith and retain faith in the strength of common purpose and in the strength of unified action taken by the American people.
The president there speaking earlier this year on the National Recovery Administration. WLH 570 Lost Heaven Radio brings you modern music and news bulletins throughout the day. Thank you for listening.
You're late. Dinner's cold.
Work.
Hey, boss. I came as soon as I got your message.
Sit down, Tom. We have a mole, Tom.
No. Who?
I was up all night driving myself nuts trying to figure it out. I started thinking maybe it's one of our guys. We aren't paying his fair share. Someone with a light wallet.
Maybe looking to Morello for a new suit.
Frank wasn't around, so I went to the safe to get the account books. to see who's getting cents on the dollar he's earned.
What do you know?
The books are gone, Tom.
Frank.
More than 50 years I've known him. Everything I have, I got with Frank. And every buck we've earned, every dime we've paid out, it's all logged in those books. Frank hands those over to the feds, we're finished.
Frank respects one person in this whole town, and that's you. This has got to be some kind of misunderstanding.
I've been calling him all day. I went by his place. He's gone. His wife and kid are gone.
But why?
I don't know. I'm sure he has his reasons. Maybe he's still smarting over the dog.
The one you tried to drown.
Yeah. Same one I shot after he wouldn't let me sink her. I was a stupid kid, Tommy. But grudge or no grudge, we gotta get those books back. Shake down all our stories. See who knows what. And when you catch up to Frank, you get those books. And if he doesn't have them on him, you make him tell you where to find them. After that, you do what we gotta do.
Vincenzo's waiting for you with a clean car.
Tommy?
Tough day today, Tom.
We gotta keep a lid on this, Tom. Start with Biff, but don't give him nothing. I got you a clean set of wheels. And something special here, if you want it. When Frank sees a LaPara, he'll know. The old ways work. Whatever it takes, Tom.
Of the tragedy. He also spoke of the survivors' rescue by the German tanker, Phoebus. President Roosevelt has described the loss of the Akron as a national disaster and said that he grieves with the wives and families of those lost and the nation. We will bring you more on the disaster and the Navy's search as we receive it. Thank you for listening. We return now to our scheduled programming. This is WBDS, broadcasting live from Behringer. Does he pay more attention to women on the street than to you? When was the last time he paid you a compliment? Make sure that he only has eyes for one woman with a visit to Behringer's cosmetics department.
Tommy, what's the rumpus?
Heard any big news lately?
Something that Don might want to know.
It depends. What's it worth to you?
$20.
How about 40?
All right, spill.
The FBI's in town. They're getting something from Morello, but I don't know what.
How'd you hear?
Little Tony got some guy drunk in the Black Cat and drove him home. Heard a bunch of stuff, so he's the guy you want to see.
Okay. Thanks.
Always a pleasure, Tommy. Oh.
WLH Sports Report. There's a sense of anticipation as we await the start of the big game. Our very own Lost Heaven Lancers are out on the road, deep in enemy territory as they take on bitter rivals, the Empire Bay Cannons. This year's Gold Series is shaping up to be one of the best on record, with both teams matching one another blow for blow. Despite the Cannons' home field advantage and an early lead in the series, the Lancers have bounced back and have really taken their rivals to task. Many of the plaudits and column inches have been dedicated to one man. Lancers pitcher Bunny Smith is...
How you doing?
Everything okay, Tom?
Nah, it's not. What's this about the guy you drove home who's with the feds?
He came in for a drink, which turned into 10. He's hired muscle for some kind of safe house.
Where?
Oak Hill, corner of Pine. He gave me $10 to drive him back and keep my mouth shut. Let on that Councillor Ghillotti's brokered some kind of deal between Morello and the FBI. They were all ready to sit tight on someone in there.
Why the hell didn't you tell us?
Tom, I did. I came in to see French straight away. He didn't tell the Don?
No, he didn't.
Tom, what's going on?
We return now to the coverage of Game 7 of the Gold Series. And by the looks of it, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be underway any minute now. The crowd here in the Armory are restless. You can almost taste the tension as...
Looks like the place. Take me to those account books, Frank.
And we return now to coverage what could be the final play of this game.
Gotta be some kind of meat happening. Shit. They taking you to the airport, Frank? Christ, they're flying him out of state or something. Fuck, this ain't good.
he's not supposed to be here. Hey, don't give me a reason. Hey, this guy's not one of them.
Get to his side! Hey, he's injured. Ten says he's fine.